Can you hear me well on the back side? Do you want me to speak louder?
Yes, please.
Yeah? Oh, okay. So it was 3 years ago I came to Vienna. I didn't speak German. My English also was very bad. And yeah, and I was on German course. I started to participate the classes at the TU. It was fun. After that, like, I always wanted to start my own business at that time. 3 years ago, I was already programming microcontrollers on open source platform, which is called Arduino. And what I realized is that the programming language on this platform is not accessible for people who don't know anything about coding and the technology. And I decided to create the product, basically the robot that anyone can build and program. And yeah, but I didn't have any business experience, and I decided to go to Pioneers. It's a company behind the Pioneers Festival. It's a huge tech conference that takes place here in Vienna every year. And I joined their marketing team and helped organize the conference. And during the conference, I met my co-founder Anna. And she is actually from Ukraine originally, and we decided to start to work together just after the conference without signing any contracts and stuff like that. And what happened next? And after that, we actually created the first prototype and applied to one competition that was organized by a huge robotics venture capital fund. And we actually prepared a very, very cool application video, which I want to show you right now. It was in Russian, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sorry. There are actually subtitles.
Ah, okay.
Yeah,
yeah.
Okay.
Great.
Oh, yeah. Basically, what I learned from that is that you can sell something with a good marketing, even if it looks ugly. Don't be afraid to launch when the product is not ready. So, and after this video, we won the competition. We're covered by the biggest media. And we started to receive a lot of emails, like some guys wanted to buy this robot to their girlfriend for birthday. So that's really funny. Yeah, and I understood that there is a lack on the market, and we just have to continue to work on this product. So we built a great team. We had engineers, me, the person that have experience in marketing, Anna, and the great designer Yuri, the guy from video, from the video. And the okay, like we have a great team. What's the next problem for a hardware startup? Like, what do you think was the biggest challenge was for us at that time?
Financing.
Maybe, yeah, that's one of the. And the second, we're making hardware product. What's the problem? Try to guess. Manufacturing. Okay, so and we had to understand how we need to manufacture those robots, and yeah, and we applied to hardware accelerator that was based in Shenzhen, China, and they accepted us and invested $50,000, and we moved to China for half a year to work with the factories to understand how the manufacturing works. And we moved there. It was horrible time. I mean, it's great to, you know, visit China when like you're a tourist, right? Working for the factory with something more, but we survived that. It was like half a year Chinese adventure. We came back to Vienna, became robotics project of the year, became top 8 startup on Pioneers Festival, the festival I was working for last year. And so and we actually figure out the next vision of our product. We started to talk to our users, to our customers that wanted to use our product, and we started to hear their ideas. And they said that okay, if you're making it for kids, then the favorite toy of all kids is, any ideas? Yeah, right, Lego. And they asked us to make it look like Lego, and we came up with a new idea to make it to embed all the electronics we have into the cube, so that the kids can play with it like they play with Lego.
Sounds a good idea.
For many parents, education and play have always been two separate worlds. So this smart brick was invented, the brick that changes everything. With these bricks, I can build really cool things. Robo is a revolutionary robotics kit for kids of all ages, which can be programmed and controlled with smartphones and tablets. Robo's smart brick can be attached to either side, so I can make different robots. The app lets you program and control it in the most intuitive way. Just choose actions, combine them, and we're ready to go. Together with Robo, I'm confident I will build the future of technology. I love my new friend.
With new concepts, started to test it with our users, kids, parents, teachers, educators from all over the world, and it was a great time. Like, there is one advice for you: always test your product with your users and ask for feedback and improve your product based on this feedback. In 2015, we became Startup of the Year in Vienna, in Austria, and finally, the goal for 2015 was to actually start selling the robot, right? We're like working almost 1.5 years just on product without making any revenue. And we were invited by TechCrunch to launch our product on the stage of the TechCrunch Disrupt in San Francisco, which is the most prestigious tech conference in the world. And we launched it and got pre-orders from 58 countries. From 1,200 people, and we raised $250,000 just in 5 weeks, which is really amazing. And we basically, I'd like to show you the video. Probably you saw it already, but I'd like to show it one more time.
understand, and this is the RoboCube, and it will change how our kids learn about technology.
Introducing Robo Wunderkind, a revolutionary robotics kit for kids of all ages, which can be programmed and controlled with smartphones and tablets. RoboCubes can be attached from either side so you can make different robots.
2 years ago, I was studying computer science at the Yale University of Technology, and I was building robots on Arduino platform. My friends were fascinated by what I was doing, and they also wanted to build their own robots. There was no financing way for them to get started. This is why I decided to create a robot that would be easy to build and code, and would be accessible for everyone.
We're embedding different electronics, such as microcontrollers, sensors, motors, taking cameras into the cubes. This way, kids can easily build unique robots with different functions and in any shapes they can imagine.
I think it's really important that kids introduce technology at a very young age. And I think Robo is a really interesting platform for enabling these kinds of things. It sort of makes the robotic technology accessible.
The biggest engineering challenge for our team was to create a connection system between the cubes. We created a technology that will be easy to grasp even for a 5-year-old child, and it works perfectly. Just attach the cubes, build the robot, and connect them to each other via Bluetooth.
We've created an intuitive app that kids really love. You don't have to write any code to program the robot, just jack in the blocks in the app and press start. Teachers love the way kids learn by playing with the robot. That's why we've also developed a community room for teachers on how to use robot when they can use the classroom.
Robo introduces the younger students to authentic 21st century skills, and it targets an age group that sometimes doesn't really have that opportunity.
With our amazing robotics kit, we are teaching children 3 key skills: robotics, coding, and creative thinking. And there is one more thing. We've made an adapter that will make Robo Wunderkind compatible with your Legos. All of our backers on Kickstarter will receive these adapters so that you can bring your toys to a whole new level.
We started working on Robo Wunderkind 2 years ago to improve kitchen and coding and robotic science.
And now we need your help to start production.
Support Robo on Kickstarter to make technology accessible.
And this is that just the beginning. The third advice that I can give to you: don't be afraid to fail. If you become successful, if you fail 10 times one after another, if your 11th time will be successful, no one will remember that you failed this first 10 times. Like, the most important is what is in the end. So don't be afraid to fail. And the goal for this year for us is organizing manufacturing. We have to ship our product to 58 countries. I don't know how we're gonna do it, but I'm going to China next month to figure out how to do that finally. And so yeah, that's pretty much it. I'm here to inspire you. I think you have more chances to succeed than me, because you heard my story. Get out of the box, launch as soon as possible, and create cool things. I wish you best of luck with that.
Thank you for this inspiring story, Rustem. Would any one of you have any questions to Rustem? Yeah, please.
I have two questions. The first one is, what was your main challenge? I mean, what was this moment when you say, "This, I'm going to drop it, I just give up"? And this is the first question. When did it happen, this? And the second question, when do you think it would happen again in the future when you're growing up? Because right now you have a really big business. It comes with a big challenges, and the next moment when you will fail, it will be even worse now. So that's all. Good question.
So the biggest challenge in the beginning was, I think, to find the right idea. I remember the moment when I was like laying on my bed in my dorm room, and like I had like the choice whether I'm choosing this idea and starting it and moving, because actually if you start something, you should know that you're ready, you'll be ready to work on this idea next 10 years. If idea is not like that, don't even start. If you start something, you have to feel that you are ready to work on this many, many years in future. And I asked myself whether I want to work on this idea next 10 years. I said yes. The reason, because I want to improve education. I want to make technology accessible for everyone. And this is the big goal. And I'm ready to sacrifice, to invest my time in future and my energy to make to achieve this big goal. And the challenges in future, I think they're going to be big challenges, and I don't think that this problem is like a part of the game of being an entrepreneur. Like challenges is like fun. It's cool.
I have a more practical question. I'm actually wondering, in the whole process of like coming up with the idea and then executing, and it has taken how many years now? Two?
Sorry?
How many years has it taken now so far?
We started in November 2013. It's like 2.5 years.
2.5 years. So in the meantime, how do you make a living?
So like we got first $10,000. It was enough to fund our three co-founders. Mm-hmm. And then in summer 2014, we got investment of $50,000, which was enough to actually get to the next milestone. After that, we won several awards in Austria, like with the money prizes, and we launched Kickstarter. That's how we found ourselves. Mm-hmm. Any other question?
I have a question. There's one. Yeah, Ivan, go ahead.
Could you say, we probably mentioned them already, but anyway, that what were the actions that you took that enabled you to be here where you are now, but if you haven't taken them, mm-hmm. you wouldn't probably succeed or move that much forward. What were the actions that you took that made the difference that you are here?
Good question. The actions? I think you should choose the right partners. I think starting working together with Anna, my partner and my co-founder, I think it was a very important decision. The next, like choosing the right idea, of course. Deciding to moving to China. It's also like big decision, because now we are like feeling pretty confident with in manufacturing, and yeah, like I think choosing the right co-founders, it's something really, really important, and that can affect your future a lot. Yeah. Any questions?
Do you miss that you didn't finish university?
Sorry?
Do you miss that you didn't finish university?
Actually, no. Like, I'm feeling pretty good. Yeah, I don't need university. I'm feeling pretty okay. Yeah.
How much knowledge did you have in the field of creating or coding in general?
Honestly, I don't have big experience in coding and technology. I'm just like hobby guy. I'm like, I just like internet and like surfing the internet, reading stuff and that like that. I'm not like hardcore engineer at all. Yeah.
I have another question.
Yeah.
Do you still remember what you wanted to become when you were a kid? Do you have any idea?
I wanted to become a president of my country.
You're just satisfied now, I guess, right?
Huh?
And you're satisfied now, not being the president of your
Yeah, of course I'm satisfied.
Next step.
Any other questions? Ask questions.
How would you describe your impact?
On what?
On children, on education, whatever it
so,
might be.
So, I can't say that we made a big impact so far. I think we're making big impact in Austria, because like we're showing that we can make a cool hardware startups here in Austria, and we're like a bunch of international guys that are starting a company here in Austria and earning some money.
Mm-hmm.
That's one impact. The second, like regarding the product, I think we'll make a big impact in future, because we want to teach children robotics and the coding starting from age of 5, and that's something really, really impactful. Because like I actually started this idea because I didn't. I always wanted to have that kind of toys in my childhood. Like we want to make something, you know, complicated to children's hands as early as possible, because it's really important to give this kind of superpower to show that they can create complicated things with their hands, but it's kind of cool. And we want our first users, kids, to become inventors, coders, maybe the creators of the future with our product.
Yeah, another question.
I'm a teacher for primary school, and my aim is that my kids play as much with wood and grass, and that they get dirty and that they breathe fresh air.
Uh-huh.
When I hear this, my first feeling was like, play with the grass, please, or something. What would you tell me? Like, how would you convince me that like this, is good?
I mean, it depends on. Who do you want your kids to become in the future? Like here with this product, we are preparing future engineers, designers, the creators of the future technologies. It depends on what you want. If you want your kids to like play with grass in the future, I mean that's your choice, right? But if you want them to become cool engineers, to become successful, to get a cool job in the future, then that's the toy for them.
And I guess they can play with this and learn from this, but still play with it.
They can still put grass on it.
I just wanted to show that I think that our children in our days are really into electronics and stuff like that. I don't say this is bad or something, I just say this like feeling I had, and
now it's a very valid question. It's a very valid question, but I believe that as Rustem as well explained, I think it's very important for us to also follow the future trends and what is happening with the labor market and how things will change, and it is very important for kids to be educated in the new trends as well. There was a question here as well. Yeah.
So what was more difficult for you, to create your product or to present for seeking for investors and stuff like that?
It was complicated.
It was more complicated.
Yeah, I don't know. Everything was complicated. But like, what's more complicated? I don't know. It's a very hard question, actually. What was complicated? Actually, nothing is complicated for me. Like, we used to complicated things, and like, it's like kind of just solving the problem. It's like our daily life solving complicated problems.
I think what this question is more aiming at is kind of the same as I was asking. Meaning, everyone knows that it's how to actually like make a like program something. I have no fucking clue how to do this. And I think it's incredibly hard. And like if I just look at a matrix at the movie, I think, okay, that's how it goes. Obviously it's not like this, and I understand that it's way easier, you just need to kind of get into the topic. But it's like the step when you kind of like the leader of such a thing, as you are, like of this project or of this startup, how much do you have to get into this topic, or do you have just like kind of your guy who's doing this, and you have to be able to tell him, okay, that's what I want, and kind of direct him best possible?
That's actually a very good question. I think that's the question of all the all the founders of the company, right? Because, do you need someone like just hiring like a technical guy or someone, and you want like tell him like make this how I want, but usually it doesn't work because the first founder of the company, usually CEO, must be like the keeper of the vision and the first creator, right? Like you can't just outsource your initial idea to someone else because they don't know what is in your mind, right? Of course you can like explain them somehow, but they don't have any motivation to actually perform this task. So I think if you want to become a CEO and the founder in the company, you should you are the keeper of the vision, and you should at least understand the topic and the understand what you want to do, and at least draw it on paper. Yeah.
How is it to be a startup in Austria, or why did you choose Austria? I mean, it would make a difference to go to Berlin or to Sweden or whatever.
We decided to stay here because of our team members from Austria, and it's like one of the most common questions of other startup founders: why Austria? Why not Silicon Valley, for example? I think Austria has many benefits in terms of starting a company. One of the biggest benefits, from my perspective, I think that you don't have any Google, Apple, and other cool companies that are hiring cool people for like very, very big salary. And as a small startup, you have bigger chances to get cool people on board, like a talented designer, engineer, or someone else for affordable salary. And that's one of the benefits. Why we're in Austria? Like all of our team members from here, we have a lot of support. Everything is cool. It's the coolest city in Europe, and the Vienna has the coolest startup scene.
One last question, and then we're closing. Yeah.
To ask, do you really see yourself as a social entrepreneur or as an entrepreneur?
I'm social entrepreneur since I'm here. Right.